What's going on, everybody? Gentleman94 here. Welcome back to Ben Builds. This is episode number 12 for the P-36, and today we're going to get this thing finished and show you how it turns out. So, last episode, we put on the decals. Those are dried. We are ready to go. We put on a clear coat of future floor polish on top of those decals to kind of seal them up. That is cured. Next is the weathering. Now, weathering is difficult for me. I'm not really adept at it, but let's see what I can do, what I can come up with. So I like using colored pencils. I like using this barrel color for paint chips, which we'll use for any sort of nicks in the paint on the wing walks or maybe on the decals or on the cowling. I love the gray color, not too stark. We also have this regular old mechanical pencil. I can use this for burnished metal look, maybe around the, you know, canopy sliding rails or the canopy itself. I don't know. We'll see. I've got the AIM weathering powder, dark gray in color. I'll use that for a sludge wash, which we'll do a little later. And I have some Tamiya smoke, just in case I wanted to bust out the airbrush for any sort of exhaust stains. I may not use it. We'll have to see. I do have some Testers oil wash that I made up from Testers Flat Black and Testers Rubber. We could use that if we need to. And I have a regular old automatic pencil that we can use for the eraser part and for any sort of tiny little burnished metal parts we might want to use. That's about it. So we're going to go ahead and weather this whole model down. And then the last step, we'll put on the pilot point and we'll put on the aerials. Now the aerials come out of the rear tail. There's actually three of them. One from the tail down to the end of the wing here by the navigation light. And again, on the opposite side to the navigation light. And there's a third one that either comes in off the tail about to the middle of the fuselage here, about right where the six is, or off of that third aerial. I'm not sure which. We'll have to look at our references and figure that out. But let's move along, get our sludge wash going. Okay, so the AIM dark gray weathering powder is going to go great with a little bit of dishwashing liquid and some water. We'll mix all that up, we'll get ourselves a nice sludge wash, and then we'll just push it around the model and get it all dirtied up. Okay, so I am going to be shoving this all over the model in every nook and cranny and every panel line, getting this thing nicely coated. I like the dark gray as opposed to like the grimy black, which I also have, because the dark gray is going to give it just a hint of weathering. I'm kind of thinking that since this is an early war airplane, they aren't in combat, they haven't seen combat, so they're going to be cleaner. But because this is an older version of the P-36 and they're being phased out for the more advanced P-40s, I don't think it would be as meticulously taken care of as, say, like a P-40 would have been or one of the later P-36s. So that's kind of my idea behind how I'm going to weather this thing. I don't want to put too much weathering on it, but I also don't want it to be purely, you know, right out of the museum, right out of, you know, the showroom floor. I want it to be dirty, just not distressed too much. So I think the dark gray weathering powder in the sludge wash is going to be perfect for that application. But you know what? This is all an experiment. We'll have to find out and see how it goes. All right, so it's all dry. I've let it sit for about 30 minutes and everything looks decently covered. Again, it's just for a subtle shift. It's not to be so blatant. I have our water here and we have our paper towel. Get a little bit of water on that paper towel and we're going to use that to kind of wipe off some of the sludge wash and kind of draw it, at least in the direction of the airflow. Now we're going to again just draw it across the wing so that it all looks like it's kind of being pushed along and kind of flowing over the wing surfaces. I'm not going to take all of it off, just a little bit here and there. Because again, I want to leave a little bit of that darkness, a little bit of gray in kind of the recessed sunken areas. And I might want to go back over it with a little bit of oil wash just to kind of darken them even more. I don't want to weather it too much, like I said though, just enough to give it a subtle shift in color from the silver to the gray to the black. I want to give it a nice overall fade. Okay, so the sludge wash is wiped off. We're going to take the last little bit of this oil wash here, and we're going to just kind of draw it across the model to give it a little bit of variation in subtle areas. I want to work on the underside, around the wheel wells, around anything that has maybe a look of some oil that might have been accumulated there. I want to kind of get this kind of shoved into different areas, and hopefully that will give us a nice little variation on top of the overall dark gray that we've washed this thing down with. And also in the exhaust ports, we want to put some nice bit of oil wash in there and streak it kind of back a little bit as if, you know, maybe darkened a bit more. And I'm just going to cover the whole aircraft more so in areas I think that would be really dirty. And then I'm going to let this sit for a little bit, and I'm going to wipe some of it off and just really work maybe some Q-tips in certain areas and get this thing looking a little more weathered, just a tiny bit. I'll take off some of the areas here and there, but I'll leave the majority of it in the panel lines. I'll also do the underside as well, and I'll go right over the decals. That's why we overcoat the decals with some sort of protective covering. All right, it's looking pretty good. I like how this is coming out. So we have put on the sludge wash. We have gone over certain areas with the oil wash. And now, as you can hopefully see, we have a nice, decent finish. We're going to use our colored pencil now. We're going to go into the different areas, and we're going to just mark them a little bit to give it a little bit of a variation so that it looks like maybe people have walked on it, maybe it's chipped a bit from people, you know, excessive use, you know, just a little bit. Again, I want to be subtle about this. I hate overly weathered aircraft. I like subtlety. So I'm going to use just a little bit of colored pencil here around the different panel lines where I think people would have stood. Because again, this is pre-war. We're not fighting anyone at this time, so I want this to look like it's been used, but it's been maintained. And I think a little bit of chipping would be sufficient. I don't have to go overboard on it. I think the pilot would get it on the opposite side, but I still want to chip both sides just in case, you know, there's some story behind it. On the opposite side, this should be the side that the pilot would get in and out of, so I want to weather this a little heavier. But again, not too heavy, because like I said, I want to be subtle about it. And I'm just going to hit the high points right there at the wing root, some of the areas of panel lines, and then anything maybe at the trailing edge of the wing. And again, I'm just kind of drawing the colored pencil along the area where I think there might have been a bit of marks. I can also use it kind of in a stippling motion to give it a little bit of variation as well. I'm also using the same technique on the cowling. I wanted to come in here with the colored pencil and just give it a little bit of color variation with the colored pencil as if maybe some paint has been chipped off by rocks or by maintenance crews, just a little bit. Again, I like subtle weathering. I think that looks pretty good. I like that. I like just a subtle variation, subtle changes here and there. So we're going to continue, see what we can come up with. I've done the back section too. There's a hatch right here on the side of the fuselage. I've also kind of weathered that area up too. Just a little bit here and there. I want to hit just strategic areas, kind of what I feel would be appropriate for this era of aircraft. If I don't like anything, I can rub it off with my finger, or I can take an eraser and just erase it. It's no big deal. That's why I like using colored pencil. I think this is looking really cool. All right, everybody. So I've been working off camera here, and as you can see, this thing is decently weathered. It's not too heavy-handed. I think it's just enough. It's subtle enough that it gives the impression of that being weathered. And you can also see, hopefully, that I put an aerials on. I did that off camera because I'm new to the aerial game and it was very difficult to get these things done. But I poked a small hole in the edge. I strung one of the aerials from the edge all the way to the wing, and I just used some super glue on each of the ends. And so far, it's holding, and I think it's going to look just fine. Now, we also have to come back and we have to cover this in a flat coat because I don't want this to be rubbed off and I don't want this to not be sealed. For the flat coat, I have a ton of this stuff. So I'm going to use this. I'm going to use nice, broad, sweeping motions. I'm not going to hold off in one place too long. It's going to nice, broad, sweeping motions and cover the whole thing in a nice, slight coat of it. All right, guys, flat coat is dry. Masks are removed. And let's go ahead and take a look at the final version of the P-36A by Academy. And here it is. This is built up in Lieutenant Rasmussen's colors and weathered. I think it turned out excellently, far better than I ever anticipated it would look. So let's zoom in and show you what I've got. All right, everybody, we are ready for the final unveiling of the P-36A by Academy in 1/48 scale. And here it is. This is a finished kit. We are done. And I'm so excited to go ahead and show you guys the finished product. So let's zoom in and let me show you a little bit what we've done here. And hopefully you guys dig it. Okay, so as you can see, we have a nice subtle variation between the silver, the black, and then the somewhat silver gray of the ailerons. We have a nice subtle fade of the weathering. I like how it looks. I think it looks great. I think it looks perfect. For me, in my mind, this is what I was going for. So again, it's subtle. I like subtle weathering. I don't like anything too blatant in your face. So we've got a little bit of chips here and there. We've got some dark gray washes that we did over top of that, you know, with the sludge wash, and we did the oil wash with the testers, the flat black and rubber. The ailerons are that gray color, that silver gray with a little bit of the chrome put into that. I really, really enjoyed how this thing turned out. The overall kit itself, top notch. Yeah, you have some fit problems. Yeah, the cockpit kind of sucks. Yeah, the wheel wells are molded in canvas, which is may not be necessarily correct. Depends, I think, on your version you're building. But the kit itself is a nice little kit. If you guys are looking at a good P-36, this one is a decent rendition of it. Yeah, it could use some work. Yeah, it could use some resin updates. But I think overall, it's a very nice little kit. If you guys are looking for a nice little P-36, consider the Academy kit. It's nice. It's clean. It's got some good markings. No problems with decals. We scratch built the interior of the wheel wells. We took care of some seat belts. We kind of spiffied up the internal cockpit just a little bit. But I did keep the canopy closed. We are done. That is it. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed this build series. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for all the positive comments, all the positive, you know, feedback. I really appreciate that. Tune in next time when we have a brand new kit. We'll get some good stuff going for you guys. So thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time on Ben Builds Season 4.